Here we are in Parque Nacional Metropolitano, virtually unperturbed jungle, mere minutes away from Panama City. This used to be a US military base, so there are some ruins. However, the vast majority of this is pure forest. Fascinating. I do hope you enjoy this, guys.
When I'm in a crowd, on an island by myself, silent or too loud, wishing I was somewhere else. And I can't believe you hit me fast and hard when you turn to me and say, never change the way.
Hello, Skaz. Me again. Here's a rather large tree, probably at the very top of the canopy. They have a canopy crane here that Smithsonian researchers use to study the canopy, and it's actually available to tourists. So we're gonna try to do that. Hopefully get a nice view of some wildlife. A lot of sloths like to hang out in the canopy, we've been told. So hopefully get a glimpse of those. Here we have spotted what appears to be some rather sad deforestation. Hopefully, as we continue on our journey, we will not see any more of this. Here we have a rather incredible tree. One of the largest we have seen thus far is called the Espave tree. Magnificent. As you can see, this jungle is rather immersed in urban life. There are cars right alongside it. And you even have humans interfering in the ecosystem.
This is not one.
Bringing their mass-produced products, littering the environment. Look at this guilty human smile.
I'm gonna take the trash with me. No worries.
Oh, good job, human. Here we see man disturbing wildlife in their attempts to be humorous. It is imperative that you watch your step, because you may not realize it, but there is an army of thousands walking in front of you. They are dangerous and they are armed. They are the fire ants. Look at them go. Relentless workers. Should you get in their way, you may meet a rather unfortunate fate. Dun dun dun.
Isn't that funny? Like a piece of yarn?
He's supposed to look like a leaf.
Man embarks on a dangerous journey to the top of the stairs, upon which we will have the 150 meter look out. skin like this. Forest is more magnificent than we imagined. There's something called the Metropolitan Park. I would say it's not quite like Central. Major key to spotting wildlife: patience and a good eye. Have to look at things that look like they're supposed to blend in, but they don't. Most people just wander aimlessly through the forest. However, your senses must be alert, and you must be keen as ever if you are to spot a critter. You can hear some wild frogs. Enjoy. So we are nearing the end of our journey in the Parque Nacional Metropolitano. We spotted numerous critters. Mom, do you have any tips for fellow wildlife watchers?
Just make sure you watch.
Thank you, Mom. I would also like to give a wonderful shout out to my APES Block E class. Love you guys. All right. I just realized that my APES class is Block F. I am sorry. Something interesting we learned along our travels is that you do not have to come early in the morning to visit the forest. You can also come late afternoon, because that is when the animals have awoken from their siesta, because in Central America, animals coincide their siestas with those of humans. So that is a pro tip. One additional tip I have for being a good forest dweller is, remember, there are no security cameras in forests. It is an honor system. Respect the tortoises in the lake. Let them be peaceful. Do not litter. And be a good human being. That is all I have to say. Overall, very successful trip to the Parque Nacional Metropolitano. As you can see, planes fly over the park, so it is definitely not in complete isolation from the city. And there are taxis driving on the outskirts of the park. But I would say that it was a very tranquil experience. Tiring, but well worth it. I'm out. Hear some sneaky migratory birds. They come here to Panama and they stock up because there's lots of nutrients in the bay. Nice place for a bird to stop in between their journey from South and North America. Listen to them. Lots of birds, little specks in the sand. What an excited pelican.
You could change your life if you wanna. You could change your clothes if you wanna. If you change your mind, well, that's the way it goes. But I'm gonna keep your jeans and your old black hat, 'cause I wanna. They look good on me. You're never gonna get them back. At least not today, not today, not today. 'Cause if it's over, let it go. And come tomorrow, we will see. So yesterday, I'm just a bird that's already flown away.
Final moments of the day in Isla Taboga, a mere 30 minutes away from Panama City. Something very interesting. There's a lot of biodiversity, of course, because this is an island. There seems to be a grouping of various bird species on this particular piece of the island. Many brown pelicans, native bird species of sorts. Something interesting. The island is very beautiful and for the most part very clean, but there are chunks of it that are heavily polluted. For example, this section of rocks may not be the most visible at this time, but it's deeply polluted with plastic water bottles, and there are parts of town where there's not even trash cans, it's just bags of trash overflowing onto the street. And I've noticed this is a trend, actually, in Panama City as well. Very disturbing. Humans like this one come to the island for the weekend and they pollute it deeply. And it's upsetting. However, beautiful day trip.